All right, everyone, welcome to another episode of the Achievers Corner with Victoria Showme, where we share success tips and strategies with you to help you advance in your business and in your career, whatever it is that you decide to do. So we are here to just give you the resources, the tools, the tips, the strategies to moving you from where you are right now to where you see yourself in your career and your business. So today I have the honor with me in the room. Yes. So excited for this guest speaker that we have sharing with us this time. MM Washington, my goodness. Yes. So you're really going to enjoy this session. Number one, she's a TEDx speaker. If you Google her, you're going to see it is really like breaking record everywhere on YouTube. So many thousands of views. I've seen a recent TEDx talk. She is an attorney. She's a minister. She's a singer. And also she is a coach. And today we are really going to be talking about vision, impact, and purpose, because she is the queen of VIP, living your VIP life, vision, impact, and purpose. So join me as I welcome Mrs. MM Washington.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you having me on.
Thank you so much. So can you just please share a little bit about yourself with our audience today? Let them get to know you, what to do, and things like that.
Yeah, thank you. Well, I feel like you did a great job. But just to say it a little bit in my own words, like you said, I'm MM Washington, and I'd like to describe myself, you know, with everything else that Victoria has graciously said about me. The bottom line is that I am a big dreamer and an advocate for big dreamers. And, you know, you get a lot of flack sometimes where you hear people saying, you know, don't just dream, do, or dreamers, you know, they're kind of dogging big dreamers, but I'm an advocate for big dreamers, and I show and help big dreamers do take the next step of doing. So that's me.
Yes. Big dreamer. So if you've been thinking or be dreaming small, it is time to actually expand your thinking, expand your dream, because we have the advocate of big dreamer in the house. All right. So now we're going to be talking about vision, impact, and purpose. And I really just wanted to share how you got started. What gives you what motivates you to start doing what you're doing? I mean, you are a great speaker. You are a coach. I mean, advocate for dreaming big. So what kind of inspire you? What motivates you to start your journey?
Yeah, thanks for asking that. So there's a part of my life, there's a season in my life, I guess. And I think that this happens to many of us. There's a season in my life where nothing seemed to go right. Mm. It just seemed like, you know, as a child, let me back up. As a child, I was that big dreamer. I just knew that, you know, there's some people that I've talked to that say they also felt the same thing as a child. You just know that you're here to do something, to make your mark. You don't know what that is, but, you know, just think about your children or children that you know that are just, I'm going to do this and I'm going to, you know, and you're just boundless. There's nothing, no limitations. And then life happens, you know, maybe you hear somebody, maybe a teacher tells you in school that, you know, you share your dream, your ambition, and they turn you down and say that, you know, maybe you should think about doing this. That happened to me. Or, you know, you go through life and, you know, maybe divorce, maybe death, maybe abuse, whatever, you know, life happens. And sometimes it's not even as devastating as that, but something happens that just makes you shift and put your big dream, put your goal, your ambition, those things you wanted to do on the shelf. So that was my story. One day I woke up and it was like, what has happened to the last 13 years of my life? Wow. Literally 13 years. What happened to this girl who was in law school and was, you know, ready to set the world on fire? And now here I am, single mother, two young boys, moved back home with my parents, things like that. And it was like, you know, I accepted that this was, this was just my life. I was just going to, you know, do the best for my children, forget those big dreams, and just move on with life. And, but a series of things happened. One of them being my mom passing away. And, you know, and I realized by her passing that, you know, I was very devastated, first of all. But then over time, I came to realize that, you know, my mom had fulfilled her purpose on earth. And she, you know, would we have loved her to live much longer? Absolutely. But she could proudly say that she's, you know, she has fulfilled her purpose. And so I had to ask myself, have I done that? If I were to go today, would I be able to say that? And the answer was no. Wow. And so I just began. So like a lot of the things that I've been able to do have happened. You know, my mom passed away 6 years ago. They've happened within the last 4 to 6 years. Yeah.
Wow. I mean, you know, just sharing that, it can be applicable to this season that we are going through.
Absolutely.
You know, such a season that is so, we are so unsure. Number one, I don't think anybody planned for this or anticipate things to be like this. But then this is the reality that we are living in, month out.
Yes.
So, you know, how can you kind of share that to kind of let people know how they can find their passion, how they can get themselves back and be able to put themselves on that line, you know, to follow their passion, to follow their purpose? How can you speak of that to kind of help other people to say, you know what, wake up, it's time.
Yeah. And I mean, that it just goes back to that question that I asked myself, like if today were to be my last day. And so today, you know, is not your last day. Yes, we're in this season of pandemic, but the truth is we're all in this, right? And so, you know, some of us, of course, are dealing with a lot more than others. You know, some of us were not in the best place even prior to the pandemic. So I'm not trying to minimize that, but I always like to talk about hope and say that, you know, if you give up hope, then what else do you have? Like, there's nothing else. Okay. Like, you might as well just, you're going to, like, tomorrow's going to happen whether you like it or not. I mean, as long as God has you here on this earth, tomorrow's going to happen. So how do you want to embrace that tomorrow? It takes the same amount of energy to operate from a place of hope as it does from a place of hopelessness. And actually, it might even cost you more. It actually might be more draining to operate in that depressed, hopeless state, you know? And so right now with COVID, it might look like, you know, what can I do? I've lost my job. There's, you know, things like that. And again, I do not want to be the one to minimize. That is not what I'm saying. But there's something. For instance, you know, take a look at some of the things that lit you up when you were a child. When you were younger, you know, we talked about a few minutes ago about when I was a child, I said I was going to do this and do this. What are the things that lit you up as a child, and how can you find a way to incorporate them into your life right now? Is it possible? Absolutely. You know, you might have to make some tweaks and adjustments because, of course, you know, at the age you're at, you're not going to be rolling down hills and things like that. But, you know, that's a place to start. What are the things that annoy you about, you know, about the world today? And I don't just mean like, you know, those little things that, you know, I can't stand when people go past the speed limit, you know, not that kind of thing. But things that can affect the world, you know, those are some things that, those are some examples of things that where you can make an impact, where you can plug yourself in and make improvements. A last question I'll share is, you know, a lot of times I speak a lot about visionaries and I work with visionaries. And the question that a lot of visionaries answer, whether indirectly or directly, is there's got to be a better way to XYZ, to whatever that is. So what things have you thought about and experienced in your life that you're like, there's just got to be a better way to do this? You know, that's how things like Uber got started. That's how Starbucks, you know, and all of these modern day things that are now like great all over the world, that's how they got started. And a lot of them started in an economy just like this.
Wow, I mean, it's so great, you know, sharing that, because if you look at this time, what is going on around us, number one, I mean, like you said, we are not minimizing the effects of what this COVID has caused, but at the same time, is to put things in perspective. This season is not going to be here forever, but just to learn from this season and just, you know, starting from what is it that you were passionate about when you were younger, and then because life happens, and then you put it on hold, and now maybe COVID is happening again, and you're thinking, oh God, maybe this is not the right time, but to see that, you know what, as long as I'm still here, there is a plan for me, and to think like, okay, what is my purpose? Asking yourself that question. Can you say that I have fulfilled my purpose? Have I unleashed everything within me? Can I say I have, can you check off everything on your list? Like, oh, I have done this, I have done this, I've made impact in this area. So if you haven't, so it's just the time to say, you know what? Let me sit back a little bit.
Yes.
Put things in perspective and then begin to put things in alignment. You know, like how you said, talking about hope, don't give up on hope. But just thinking that the situation happening right now, the areas that you can improve on for you to be able to get started.
Right.
You're talking about Uber. I mean, there were taxis before, yellow cab, all of those has been around. But then somebody think like, there should be a better way, a better way, a better way, you know? These days, people cannot have like one-on-one meeting again. But now there is a better way. If you cannot do in person, what are the other better way of doing things? No, virtual, a lot of virtual meeting, virtual conferences. So you're just thinking about, okay, what is it? There is a better way of doing certain things.
Yes.
And because the thing is, and you are not alone. If you think like, oh, you are alone. No, people also are looking for a better way of doing things. So thank you for sharing that. So for people now who are getting into that mindset, now thinking, you know what, I need to really get back to the basics. I need to get this going. So what can you share, some inspiration, give them some inspiration, some things, some tools that can really help them to kind of like get over that hump and get started and keep moving?
Yes, absolutely. For me, my the tools that work for me so far, and I think I will use these tools for the rest of my life. Number one is a coach. And a lot of times when we hear coaches, you know, just like when I was talking earlier, sometimes coaches might have a bad rap. When I say dream big, some people are like, don't dream big, get a coach. Some people are like, who needs a coach? But for me, and what a coach provided for me was accountability for sure, and strategy, and just clarity, just the ability to have my some clarity with my thoughts. You know, maybe I was thinking one way and not understanding, well, how do I go from A to B? And so that's where strategy would come in. So a coach might have suggested, offered different suggestions, or where I'm thinking there's just so much in my head, and how do I, you know, clear that fog, and a coach provided that for me. And the accountability for me is huge. I tell you a story about accountability. Years ago, I was on a popular weight loss program. I won't say the name, but I was on this weight loss program, and you go in, the thing was, you go in once a week to get weighed. You stand on the scale, the person that's there writes down, and then you go sit down in the office and look through and see, well, where were you last week and where are you this week? That's when I first learned that accountability works well for me. I do well if I have to be accountable to somebody, mm-hmm. because there's that element of integrity, you know, like, mm-hmm. well, I've given my word, so I'm going to have to, you know? And so with that, like, I would go for my weigh-ins on Saturday mornings. And so, like, when I leave there, I'm excited. Okay, you know, I've lost 3 pounds, you know? And so that Saturday and Sunday, maybe even Monday, I'll go eat and drink and just treat myself.
Self, yes.
But then, like, come Tuesday, I'm like, okay, you know, I'm going to have to go in.
Saturday, I got to get back.
Exactly. So, you know, I'll just, you know, get on point so that when I get there, there's that, you know, the scale has gone in the right direction. And so that's the same thing with a coach, for me, a life coach, business coach. It's just that accountability. Well, you know, here are some things that you're going to do in the before our next meeting. And so then I would get to work so that by the time I get to that next meeting, I'm not there empty handed. So that's a coach. Also podcasts. You know, kudos to you, Victoria, for having this podcast. You know, it's, and I love, you know, the Achievers Corner. I love that title, you know, but podcasts such as yours help me a lot. You know, you might think, well, I've got so much on my plate. I've got so much to do between kids and work and this and that and COVID. When do I have time to listen to podcasts? If you can't watch them, listen. While you're doing dishes, while you're driving. There was a point in time I would drive an hour to work and an hour home. I loved listening to podcasts. That was like my time, my me time.
Yes.
To just pour into myself. So podcasts and definitely books, you know, books, self-help. I'm a self-help junkie, personal development junkie. You know, I believe in constantly just trying to improve yourself. And so books, those are some tools that you can start with. And the podcasts and the books are either free or, like with books, you know, they're low cost. Coaching, of course, there's an investment, but the point is it's an investment. It's an investment in yourself. And so when you invest, you expect a return on your investment. And if you do it the right way, you will get a return on your investment.
Wow. Guys. Ooh, yeah, those are like really nuggets that she shared with us, you know, few things about MM that you don't know. Like I said, she's really a great TEDx speaker right out there. And she has written so many books. I'm telling you, she's a speaker out there. And for her to be sharing that, those are the things that have helped her in the journey, you know, because sometimes when you are stuck, when you kind of, you've lost yourself, you don't even know how to get yourself together. Having someone following this guide, using these tools, will actually really help you to bring about total transformation. Like you shared, even myself, when I first heard of coaching, I always think coaching are for big people like me, coach. My God, can I afford that? Mm-hmm. And then when I met this lady online on Facebook and she invited me to a mastermind group, I was like, okay. I mean, that was the first time I was hearing some terms. Like, okay, let me see how it goes. Because actually she personally reached out to me and she said, oh, this will benefit what you're doing. You will learn from this. Like, okay, let's check it out. Yeah. And I did, it was about 6 weeks mastermind. It was awesome. I was like, wow, something like this exists? I don't know. Yeah. And so from there, she became my coach and got me started. I mean, and that's why I love you talking about accountability, clarity, strategies with a coach. My God. I mean, what will have taken me like years to figure out if I'm doing it by myself? Yes. It's like, we got it done in under 6 weeks. Like, Victoria, do this week. And I'm like, was like, wow. So having that coach really got me started. It got me started in 2016. I couldn't believe that.
Yes.
And the return on investment is, there is no price tag on it. Because number one, talking about the confidence. Me that couldn't speak in front of one person, I can speak in front of a large group. I mean, that is priceless. And the impact, the influence, the money. I mean, I have spoken at different conferences and everything, just starting with somebody saying, "No, Victoria, you got this."
Yes.
And providing the clarity for me, giving me the strategy, what I need to do, and holding me accountable. Like you said, each time, like, okay, I have to do this. You got to give me some homework, some assignment, and I have to do so. Next time, I have to share something. Exactly. And that is really good. So during this time that we are in, guys, if you really need the total transformation, if you really need a change in your life, if you really want to be able to follow that vision, fulfill your purpose, fulfill your passion, be able to be leave impact, not have that life of impact, this is the time. This is the season. She's talking about coaching, talking about podcasts. So many of them are free. Just download for free. And books. Oh my God. I'm like, yes, books junkie as well. I read so many books. I just love it because you get empowered, you learn something new, and then you can put something into practice. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So I want you to just share, MM, with people how they can get in contact with you and which transformation they can actually get by them working with you as a coach. You know, visionary, the dream, the advocate for big dreamer. When people work with you, what are the transformation? Share with us.
Okay, so before I answer that, I wanted to add one more thing to the resource question that you asked for the tools, and that is being around other people that are trying to do what you're trying to do, that are trying to improve themselves. Maybe you're trying to become a speaker while somebody else is trying to become an author, but you still have goals. So, and that might be right now we're not meeting live, right? So on Zoom, you know, like you said, you might join a mastermind and just be around other minded people that are trying to just better themselves. There's just something in that. And I will warn you that you will get a little bit of resistance from yourself and from others, because as you're trying to improve yourself, you know, it's going to stretch you. You're going to feel uncomfortable. You know, you're going to be stretched out of your comfort zone. Mm. And then on the other hand, when people see you changing, or even if it's for the better, you know, people want you to stay the same. And so
they're going to be a little bubble.
Exactly. And even within yourself, like, you're just like, man, sometimes you don't want to improve, or there's that resistance because you don't want to lose friends. You don't want to be stuck out of the circle or seen as doing too much and things like that. I'm just sharing things that I've definitely experienced. But being around other people that are trying to go somewhere helps you a lot. So right now, those are some things you can do. Like Victoria said, you know, there are masterminds. And so to answer your question, how I work with people as a coach, like, I like to say that I use my voice, and whether that's my singing, my voice as an author, my voice as a speaker, or as a coach, I feel like God, the way he wired me is to be able to use my voice to help people live out their purpose. And so with coaching, I've tried several things. I've tried business coaching, you know, as a coach, because I've experienced a lot of business coaches and I know so much about business coaching. I thought that that was the path for me. But what I've come to realize, and this is what I work with my clients with, is tapping in and getting in alignment with how you are created, how God created you, how you are wired. And so with my coaching program, my group coaching program that I currently have, that's what we look at. Like, even though we're in a group, we look at you individually, you know? And I spent a lot of years trying to be like other people and trying to, you know, well, Victoria is a successful, you know, coach and speaker and, so, you know, and nurse. And so I want to go do, you know, I like that. I admire her. Let me go do that. Without really looking into myself, what's my identity, and just becoming more self-aware. That's where I come in with my clients, is just really, really getting in tune with who you are so that you can go out and do the things that God has called you to do.
Wow. I mean, and I like the way you really explain it, because sometimes people, we look to certain people and we want to be like them and ignoring our own self, our own core, you know, because like, oh, that person is doing well. I think I can do the same thing. But just be in alignment with your own self, you know, being aware of who you are, the strength and what God has given to you. I mean, that is really, oh my God. Yeah, right there. That is it, guys. If you need someone to help you get that clarity to bring you back into your own alignment, being able to run your own race, not somebody else's, being able to live your own life. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Your own life, and being able to make the impact and being able to fulfill your own life purpose. Yes, so this is the God to go to. I'm telling you. And before we go, MM, she does this group coaching. Awesome. I've attended one of our events and one of the vision boarding. So very great coach, very great mentor, great teacher in that area. So if you want to be in alignment, yes, you need to connect with her. But before we wrap up, recently I got your journal, Daily Journal with Jesus, I believe I say right. I don't know if you have it there, if you can just share, because one thing I've realized is sometimes some thoughts, some inspiration comes to you, maybe while you are studying the Word of God or while you are just meditating on something. Your book, your journal is by my bedside, okay? Because something happened, we have to write things, and maybe I meditate on the verse of the Bible, I have a place to write on it. So I just wanted to share a little bit about journal, why you write that journal, why you have that, and also if you can share some of your books, and now people can get a copy, because I really love it.
Thank you so much. You gave me goosebumps by sharing, because, you know, and you know this, there's nothing greater than knowing that something that you put out has some impact on someone else's life. There's no amount of money that can give you that feeling. So thank you for sharing that with me. So you were talking about the intimate moments with Jesus, the Bible study journal, and that journal, you know, I thought when God gave me the idea, I thought this was just going to be something that I'll just put together and it'll be done in a week or two. And no, he just kept refining and refining and telling me, go back, do this, add this, and take, you know, that type of thing. And by the grace of God and to the glory of God alone, the testimonies that I'm getting, there's one lady who, like, every week, like, 2 days ago, she sent me, do you have one for children? And I'm like, I'm working on that.
I would need one for children. I'm telling you, yes, when you have the children was out, let me know. Yes, I need three of those for the kids, okay?
Thank you. That's so awesome. And so I don't have that. I actually, I'm waiting for the next stock because I have orders that have come in. And so it's, you know, and I ran out of everything. So, and my copy is downstairs. So I can't get that right now, but I can share a link to it. It's the link for every book. I think I have, luckily I have these here. So this is my CD. Sorry, this one is cracked, but it's called Rebirth. And then this is my book, Rise from the Shadows. And in this book, I do share some of what we've talked about, you know, just hiding your authentic self and really just trying not to shine, mm-hmm. you know, and not show up in the way that God created you. So those are some of the things I have. I don't have everything. I'm in the midst of studying. So yeah, but thank you for asking and for allowing me to share that.
Wow, awesome. You know, all of the things that we talk about and how to connect with MM Washington is going to be in the show notes. But today, I mean, it's just been an awesome time spending time with MM Washington. And I forgot to mention that, you know, she is owner, the founder of Motivita. So all of our products you can find there, and everything is going to be in the show notes for you to connect with her. And today, just wrapping up, no sharing about vision, sharing about impact and purpose. And now is the time to get back to the basics. Now is the time. It is okay to have missed it the first time. It's okay to not to have maybe, you know, let go of certain things, but now is time because you have the opportunity now. And you don't want to get to the point where you ask yourself, what is my purpose? Have I achieved my purpose? And the answer is no. Mm-mm. So now is the time to get back into that. And she shares with us some tips, some tools that you can use even right this moment to bring about change, to bring about transformation, talking about coaching, about podcasting, self-help books, and even finding yourself among like-minded people like yourself. People who are going somewhere, people who are aiming at something, to be among those people, because that will keep you going as well. When you see somebody moving forward, you want to follow suit. So she shared about that, and she talked about our group coaching. So all of these, we're going to put in the show notes so you can connect. So we really want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. Everybody, you go to either on Amazon right now or click the link below to get the copy of Rise from the Shadow. It's time for you to showcase yourself, to rise from the shadow, and also Intimate Moment with Jesus Journal. You need that, okay? So Miss MM Washington, please just give us a last word for our audience as we wrap up.
Yeah, so thank you. Once again, I greatly appreciate this opportunity. And for anyone that's listening, that's watching, and you might have listened to what we've shared and you're thinking, yeah, I wish you had told me this 5 years ago. Now I'm too old. It's too late, you know, or whatever. I just want to remind you, I just want to encourage you and let you know that it is not too late. Mm-hmm. You are not too old. God has a purpose for you still being here. It's up to you. And if you don't have anybody to cheer you on, find me, find Victoria. We will cheer you on to your greatness, but you're here to do something. And listen, this might sound cliche to you, but it is the truth. There's the what is inside of you, there's someone out there that needs it. And you don't have to be a creative person. You don't have to know how to write. But, you know, like my husband is very hands-on, very into using his hands, you know, into creating things. Or there are people that serve just by giving from behind the scenes, and that's how they make an impact. You are here for something. Don't think that you're too old. Don't think that it's too late. And don't think that what you have to offer is too small. That's it.
Wow, wow, wow. I mean, yes, let's end on that note. It's not too late. You are not too old. And now is the time. And somebody out there is waiting on you. I mean, somebody's destiny is attached to yours. And until you go out there and make it happen, they're going to be stuck. All right? So go and make something big happen for yourself. Dream big. You have sheer leaders here to really share you, and greatness lies inside of you. So thank you, thank you, thank you.